Fittig reaction is a reaction similar to the Wurtz reaction, which I discussed in my last video. But in this case, instead of alkyl halides, we are using aryl halides. We react aryl halides with sodium in the presence of a solvent, dry ether. And what we are seeing here, we are getting a coupling reaction in which if I start from chlorobenzene, I will get diphenyl. This is again a coupling reaction. And let me see the mechanism of this reaction. This involves the formation of phenyl radical. Phenyl radical, which is very, very unstable. This phenyl radical is very unstable. What happens in this? If I take chlorobenzene, react it with sodium, what will happen? Now this chlorobenzene, what will it do? If I take chlorobenzene, you can see that there are two molecules of the chlorobenzene and I have two atoms of the sodium. Each sodium has got one electron. And what will happen? That again you see that this is an example of homolytic fission, and sodium can give its one electron to the chlorine, and the result is the formation of phenyl radical. We have dry ether as a solvent. You know that ether is an aprotic solvent. Ether is what type of solvent? Aprotic solvent. Water is a protic solvent. Here we are using aprotic solvent. In the presence of water, sodium will react. Therefore, we do not use any water. This is a dry ether. Again, the same situation is here. What you will get here also, you see that homolytic fission and sodium giving its electron to this, and you are getting what? The formation of phenyl radicals. And the result of these phenyl radicals is that these phenyl radicals will combine. And what will they form? There will be, if this is my phenyl radical, there is another phenyl radical. And the result of this is, both are in need of electron and they will couple with each other. So what is happening? Coupling is taking place. And that's what we are saying. What you get is diphenyl. So my product is diphenyl. Very important, you see that radical is formed and these radicals are coupling with each other. Therefore, you are forming this compound and you have what you are getting, Na plus Cl minus. This reaction is very important, has been asked in exam many times. How will you question? First question, convert chlorobenzene into diphenyl. And the second type of question which has been asked in this is, convert benzene into diphenyl. This is an indirect question which can be asked. Convert benzene into diphenyl. This question was asked in the examinations. First, you will convert benzene into chlorobenzene. You already know that if I react benzene by electrophilic aromatic substitution, react benzene with Cl2 in the presence of a Lewis acid like FeCl3, you will get chlorobenzene, and then chlorobenzene you can convert into diphenyl, which is chlorobenzene. So convert benzene into chlorobenzene, and then you do the reaction which we are saying, react with sodium in the presence of ether. In the presence of ether, which is what our Fittig reaction is. Okay guys, I will meet you in my next video. In that video, I will discuss what's Fittig reaction.